In the Rose Bowl, Oregon beat Wisconsin 28-27. And it was a fun watch. I really enjoyed the game. And I'll be very honest, I want to start with this because I realized watching the Rose Bowl this year, I was like, man, I want to go to a Rose Bowl. I had this moment. I was sitting there watching and I was like, it's now the 2020s. We have 10 years of this decade ahead of us. And I was like, I'm looking at my dad on the couch. I'm like, Dad, we should go to a game at some point. I want to go to Pasadena, California to see a Rose Bowl for myself. The atmosphere is so cool. The sun, like, to start the game, the sun kind of peeks through the top of the stadium. And then as the game goes on, the sun sets. And there was this really cool moment in this year's Rose Bowl where, you know, Oregon had these chrome helmets on where they're really reflective. And the sky was turning pink and purple as the sun set. So you had Oregon's helmets looked like pink and purple as the sun, the sky reflected off of them. It was so cool and so pretty. And I love the atmosphere. I was like, man, I got to get myself to a Rose Bowl game at some point in the next 10 years. It just looks really, really cool and really, really fun. I want to start by talking about Oregon because I think Oregon, the Oregon Ducks are so, so lucky with the way that their season ended. You know, I think a lot of people, I look at Oklahoma and how their year ended. Oklahoma got into the college football playoff. They were the number four seed. I don't think they really belonged with the rest. And Oklahoma got annihilated by LSU in their college football playoff game. Oregon is so lucky they didn't make it into a game like that. You know, Oregon got to go to the Rose Bowl. And I want to ask you, 30 years from now, when an Oregon Ducks player currently looks back, you know, a current Oregon Ducks player 30 years from now looks back on his career, what memory would he rather have? Are you going to look back and go, yeah, remember that time we lost to LSU in the college football playoff? No, that's a painful memory. No, instead, Oregon is lucky enough to have the memory of winning the Rose Bowl. That's going to be a really fun memory they have. They're going to get a ring. They're going to have all kinds of, it's just going to be a fun time they're going to remember for the rest of their lives. And I think Oregon has to appreciate how fortunate they are that winning the Pac-12 got them into the Rose Bowl rather than the college football playoff. They would have got killed by LSU. It wouldn't have been fun. And I think Oregon needs to look at it that way. Like, man, it really worked out for the best for the Pac-12 and for the Oregon Ducks. I want to mention that I just feel so odd about Justin Herbert, the Oregon Ducks quarterback. I can't place it. You know, he forces throws into coverage too often for me. There was a play against the Wisconsin Badgers where it was 3rd-and-2. It was like on the 40 or 30-yard line going in. And he took a gigantic sack and lost like 8 yards. And it cost his team an opportunity to go for it on 4th-and-2. It's little things like that where Justin Herbert is oddly inconsistent. Where I just go, I have a hard time embracing Justin Herbert as a quarterback. I just, physically, he's great. He had this incredible back shoulder fade early in the game. I'm like, man, that's phenomenal. Or he had 3 rushing touchdowns in the Rose Bowl. Justin Herbert physically has all the tools, but something, I can't quite place it. It's holding me back. Now, I got to acknowledge that I love Justin Herbert's story. And I'm excited someday to dive into the film really from Justin Herbert and figure out like where does this apprehension come from with Justin Herbert? But I got to say his story is incredible. He's a kid from Eugene, Oregon, which is where the University of Oregon is actually located. And his freshman year at Oregon in 2016, the Ducks went 4-8, had a bad, miserable year. 4 years later, as a senior in 2019, they went 12-2. They won the Pac-12 championship. They won the Rose Bowl. It's so cool to me, like, the turnaround Oregon's gone through and the progression of Justin Herbert over the years. It's just a cool story to me. I like the hometown kid turns around the Ducks. Like, that's awesome. Turns around, maybe brings them back to glory is a better way to put it. But I've been questioning for a long time whether or not Justin Herbert loves football. And I got to acknowledge, man, that's a hard opinion to hold after watching him cry at the end of the Rose Bowl game. He's like, he's in this post-game interview, clearly emotional, clearly it meant a lot to him. It's hard to criticize, you know, and wonder whether or not he loves football after watching that interview. So maybe I'm wrong. I heard a really interesting comparison. It was from a YouTube commenter. A guy commented that maybe Justin Herbert's personality is more like Kawhi Leonard. I still find that apprehensive. Maybe he's more quiet and more pensive and more subtle. I don't know that I like that from a quarterback. I like quarterbacks to be more confrontational, more galvanizing. I don't know that Justin Herbert is that kind of guy. But hey, I am very willing to be more than wrong about Justin Herbert and his personality. I just have questions about it. I think it's okay to ask questions and say, we'll see more in a couple of years. I could be very wrong. I have no problem being wrong and sharing my speculation about Justin Herbert and saying, hey, this is speculation. It could be wrong. I think a lot of people misinterpret that as me rooting against him. I have nothing against Justin Herbert. I know something feels off and I cannot place it. I cannot figure out what it is. But something about Justin Herbert makes me kind of, more cautious than I normally am with other quarterbacks. Like Tua, Joe Burrow, I'm so confident. For some reason with Justin Herbert, I'm like, we'll see. Now, the star of the game to me actually was, you know, Justin Herbert had three touchdowns, but Brady Breeze, the junior safety for Oregon, I don't know if he's going to go to the NFL or not. The dude had an incredible year. It was an incredible game, excuse me. He had 11 total tackles. He had two fumble recoveries. He had a touchdown on a fumble recovery. Brady Breeze was flying all over the field. It's so cool to me. I don't care about his measurables at all. If I'm an NFL team, I look at that performance and go, I want that guy on my team. I don't know when I'll get him. I don't know if he's a starter or not, but his effort and his attitude and the way, like the heart he showed in that game was incredible. And I'm a big fan of Brady Breeze now. That safety for the Oregon Ducks, man, his effort's awesome. Flying all over the place, making plays. If I'm an NFL team, even if he's just a special teams player for me in the future, I want Brady Breeze. I know nothing about him. I knew nothing about him going into that game, but I was like, Brady Breeze was a star of that Rose Bowl. He was flying all over the place. If I'm an NFL team, I look at that and go, I want that guy on my roster. Now, I really think that Wisconsin hurt themselves in this Rose Bowl. It was really painful to me. They kept throwing towards the end of the game, especially down the stretch. Wisconsin kept throwing the ball on first and second down. And I was just, my dad and I were sitting there begging them to please run the ball, pound the rock. You have Jonathan Taylor, this incredible running back who for most of the year was a Heisman candidate. And he had 94 yards on 21 carries. If it were me calling plays, I think he would have had around 30 to 35 carries. I think they should have tried to get more out of him and utilized him more. And I feel like the word that comes to mind when I think of the way that Wisconsin used Jonathan Taylor in that game was he was underutilized. He didn't get used as much as I would have. I would have kept running on first down, second down, pounding the rock. They were getting felt like they were getting 5 yards every carry. And for some reason, Wisconsin kept trying to throw the ball. I really think it cost them down the stretch moving the football. I also got to say, Jack Cohn, the quarterback for Wisconsin. It's so interesting to me because he's very close to being great. You know, 2 years ago in 2018, we saw Joe Burrow, the guy, the LSU quarterback. He took a gigantic leap forward from 2018 to 2019. He won the Heisman Trophy this year, but last year, he was not the same quarterback. His arm strength wasn't as good, his accuracy, his timing, his all the little things that make him a great quarterback now were not present in 2018. And I think Jack Cohn is a guy that, with a little better mechanics, could have a stronger arm, with a little better footwork, could be more accurate. And because the decision-making is there from Jack Cohn, the Wisconsin quarterback, I really hope he does improve. Because if he does, those little changes he can make to his mechanics, the little changes he can make to footwork, will go a tremendous long way for him and elevate Jack Cohn to a much better quarterback. Small, subtle changes would make him a way better player. And I hope we see that. I don't know that he will, but if he gets good coaching and puts in the work, Jack Cohn, the Wisconsin quarterback, could really elevate his play in the future. I don't know that he will, because it's rare to see a guy get that much better the way Joe Burrow did. He's kind of an enigma. But I really do believe that there's a really good foundation there for Jack Cohn. And if you ever want, please, I'm begging Jack Cohn to get better, because he's so close to being a great elite quarterback. He's a good college quarterback that, if he makes subtle improvements, could become potentially an NFL quarterback with better arm strength and better mechanics. Now, regardless, my big takeaway from the Rose Bowl is that I'm just happy for Oregon. I'm happy for their fans. I'm happy for Justin Herbert. And I'm happy for Mario Cristobal, the Oregon Ducks head coach. I really like him. I'm a big fan of his. And I love the way he carries himself. I love the way he recruits. But, man, I'm happy for the Ducks. They won the Rose Bowl 28-27. And good for them.